Welcome back. We're in day three of ECDX 2019. I'm Rippy Longstocking.
I am Don't Care Bear.
And we are going to announce to you today a fabulous level two junior derby bout. I'm very excited to see these players out on the track. Would you like to tell us about our roster?
I would love to tell you. I'm going to start with the New Hampshire Junior Roller Derby. We have a much larger roster when you get to yours.
Yes.
Yes. But New Hampshire's bringing 011 Pancakes and Bacon, 0718 Rebel Storm, 11 Hermione Danger, 1101 Hella Kitty, 1105 Blue Thunder, 12 Piper the Viper, 19 Eliza Jamilton, 1967 Dread Zeppelin, 2207 Puppy Face, 23 Candy Crush, 3 Ruthless, 500 Killer Bunny, 778 Cinderblock, and 810 Bastionista.
And playing for Jersey Junior Roller Derby, it's 107 Cringe, 126 Devastator, number 13 Candy, number 222 Susie Sparkles, 23 Queenie Heart, 525 Hailstorm, 666 Psycho Psy, 709 Cupcake, and 99 Nitro. So this is level two. We were talking about it briefly before we came on air. And so if you have never seen level two derby, skaters can block one another, can touch one another, can lean into one another. They cannot accelerate into another player.
Right, so hopefully we're not going to see any of those massive hits knocking
right.
people off the track. This is kind of like a derby light.
Right.
This is seeing adults, or even, you know, level three, you see basically the same thing you would with adults. With level
Absolutely.
Two, there's still, it's a work in progress. Often you'll see slightly younger skaters in level two.
Yes.
Because they're still working their way up. So there will be contact, but it has to be light and pre-approved.
Right. And you see a lot more positional blocking in level two than you would in level three, because it's more effective, in that way.
We'll see some leaning in, and, you know, once you do make that contact, that gentle,
yes.
non-accelerated contact, you can then push people around.
Right.
So it's not that you will see no action. This can get highly intensive, because also there has to be a little bit of mental training to not be coming in too quickly. Because
right.
I know, like, I get excited, I see the back of the pack as a jammer, and I have to remember to slow down before I make any contact, or I'm just going to sit the entire time in the penalty box.
Right. And that is really interesting for... typically, it may not happen today, but a lot of times when I'm calling level one and two, actually junior, they will run jams a little bit longer than a level three, because first of all, it's not as high impact, and so the jammers don't get quite as spent getting beaten up as they come through. But also, you know, you'll see them fly around the track, and then, as you said, Bear, they'll slow down as they come in, because they don't want to get any kind of hitting penalties. And so it's a little bit slower in terms of the jammer. They'll fly around, and then they'll slow down right at the pack, and so the pack moves a little bit slower. And so the jams, there tend to be fewer jams, not to say they don't run up into the 20s, but...
And also, the stereotypical hit it and quit it, get your four
right.
points and go, might take a little bit longer.
Right.
And may not be as effective, because why stop? If you
right.
just got your 4 points, let's go get some
let's
more.
Let's go get some more, right? And they just want to skate, right? Like, they just want to get out there and do
me
their
too.
Thing. Yeah.
I don't want to forget our third team out there.
Absolutely.
Our officials for this game. We have Rex Blocker, Will Tweeton, BMD, Rob Anybody, Rhea Culpa, Danimal, Ref and Mad, Tim the Ref, and Guinness. And our NSOs for this game, Princess Bietch, Chemical Restraint, Dread Hockley, David Reed, Le Corbusier, Quick Grayson, Veronica Scars, Ms. Informed, and Tiny Parahedic.
Yes, we certainly thank them for their time and expertise out here.
Yeah, without them, this can't go on.
And I do really appreciate the skating officials being able to differentiate between a level two and a level three hit. Like, that's a skill. That one develops.
And we underway. Jersey in red, number 709. Cupcake is your first lead jammer of this game. Number 810, Bastionista in the black and pink, still fighting her way through the pack on her initial pass.
Oh, and then a nice little slip on the outside brings 4 points on the board for Cupcake.
And Bastionista right on her heels, coming around track turn four. ready to do her own scoring. That cupcake says, nah, I don't want you to have any points. They're all mine.
Yep. I'm going to come through. There was an inside lane there, so see if Cupcake was able to pick up any additional. Does not look that way. So,
yep.
4 points put on the board for jerseys. Jerseys.
The
Jersey Juniors. I meant to say two words, and I only said one.
And out here in the blue and pink, blue, black and pink, brain, come online. 11-05 Blue Thunder for New Hampshire, going up against 5-25 Hailstorm for Jersey. And Hailstorm finds that inside line, and lead jammer goes to Jersey again.
And that will be at that hitting call. You saw a little bit of acceleration there on that hit by number 107. So that's cringe. Doing a little cringe.
And
another
hitting.
That
is Rebel Storm also going to the penalty box on the New Hampshire side.
Both jammers are out of the pack, but 4 put on the board for the Jersey Juniors. Oh, nice move to the outside and going to call it off.
I don't think, Blue Thunder not able to get any points on that. Oh, I see Cinderblock out there. I called for this team yesterday, and I know a couple of fun fact. If you're watching and you think you see the same jammer out there over and over and over, there are a set of identical twins on New Hampshire, and they use that to their advantage. But this is not one of them. This is Cinderblock number 778 going up against 709 Cupcake return jammer for Jersey. And I do see another penalty. Multiplayer block being called on, not seeing number of one of New Hampshire's, Bastionista going to the penalty box on a multiplayer block. Lead jammer was ascribed to Cupcake again. And she's now come through for 4 points on that pass. Cinderblock pushing against a very effective two wall of, who is that? That is Queenie Heart and Cringe holding Cinderblock back. Cupcake returning to the pack for another scoring pass. Bastionista released from the penalty box for New Hampshire. Cinderblock a little bit of trouble on the track, took a spin, had a little trouble getting up, not sure if she hit a slick spot.
So disappointing, almost through that pack and getting reabsorbed.
Cinderblock finding that inside, Cupcake finding that inside line, excuse me, two C's, gotta keep from track. 16 points on this jam so far for Cupcake. Cinderblock just not able to get past that amazing bridged, like a London Bridge truck and trailer kind of thing. Cringe and Queenie Heart really having Cinderblock's number on this jam. I saw that one coming.
Yep.
Cupcake going to the penalty box for Jersey. And we do have a star pass. Rebel Storm now the jammer for New Hampshire after that successful star pass. Hopefully he'll be able to get a couple points in the waning seconds of this jam. Might have just squeaked. We have 2 points.
2 points.
Got that jammer. Oh, no, I lied. Did not get the point for the jammer because we do not do that anymore. I'm just so used to the block, the penalty points.
Yes.
But unfortunately, or fortunately for New Jersey.
Yeah.
Jammers don't count anymore when you count the points in the box.
So, yeah. So, 20-point jam put up for the Jersey Junior Roller Derby.
But New Hampshire did finally get some points. They were their first 2 points on the board there in Jam 3.
Important a power start here for New Hampshire.
I believe that is Hella Kitty out there. But I would be wrong. That is Dread Zeppelin. Going by the height.
Lead jammer.
Cupcake out of the penalty box.
Opportunity to get some points on the board.
Dred Zeppelin coming around for the initial pass. Oh! Well, they got that inside line untouched for those 4 points. And it looks like Cupcake returning to the penalty box, also holding her face.
So yeah, well,
that does not look pleasant.
Well, look, sometimes...
And Dred Zeppelin joining her in the penalty box. Cupcake sitting, being attended to. Her jam ref is checking to make sure she's okay to continue.
Dred Zeppelin also...
And she is coming back onto the track. Her jam ref following behind her to keep track of her progress. And immediately Cringe, her pivots like, hey, you look like you're not feeling so good. I'll take that from you. Star pass to Cringe for Jersey as Dred Zeppelin returns to the track from the penalty box after serving their penalty.
Oh, nice little move to the outside there. That was a nice little sweep.
Cringe, briefly held up by the trio of New Hampshire blockers at the front, was able to get through for 4 points.
Oh, not sure if Cringe was able to get in through that last time, but certainly nothing to be ashamed about there on that jam.
Not at all. 8 points total for New Hampshire. Only 4 for Jersey on that side, but I think they'll be okay with just the 4. Still up 36-10.
Yes.
So they'll concede those points.
On that last jam, in particular, we were talking before the broadcast began, Bear, that there is some size differences out there on the track. You'll see, and but we don't judge by size. That's not how you get to level 2. You get to level 2 by your skills and your ability.
Right, case in point, number 126, Devastator, out there for Jersey, one of the smaller skaters currently on the track, going up against number 3, Ruthless.
We've got some Devastator fans in the crowd, it looks like. On your screen, it may be a little bit difficult to tell the difference between the pink and the red because they're fairly close in terms of color. So if you're looking, so New Jersey's in the all red with the white accents. And New Hampshire's in primarily black, but they have pink stripes down the side and maybe pink across the top of their jersey. Yeah. So just in case that's difficult to tell the difference between your two colors there on your screen.
Yeah. The more non-black, that's Jersey. Maybe do we have two new jammers out there on both sides. Susie Sparkles for Junior Jersey Juniors and Hermione Danger for New Hampshire. And Hermione was able to get out and get lead jammer, but she ended up behind Susie, so she was calling it before any points were scored.
So, yeah. Okay, just making sure. Looking at some stats. Sorry about that. Our producer standing. So leads. Looks like we've been about even in terms of leads. Yeah. So far, as we got into Jam 7.
Devastator out there against Ruthless. Ruthless, another lead jam status for New Hampshire. We do see Jersey's pivot reporting to the penalty box. And Devastator also out, having completed an initial pass. And Ruthless skating through and calling it off as she's scoring those points. And I have to say, for 1 second, I need to correct an error on my part earlier. As I'm looking at the numbers, I'm like, that doesn't add up. I got my New Hampshire teams mixed up. This is not the team with the twins. That is Monadnock Roller Derby, also out of New Hampshire. So for those of you fans at home going, there's twins on this team? I didn't know that. Mea culpa from Don't Care Bear. I just get excited about all New Hampshire roller derby.
Of course.
Moving
you
on.
Do.
So now back no to problem. The what's on our screen in front of us. Ah, the Nadnock is next on track two. Yes, I should go over there and call them and be like, hey, I know you guys too. But right now on track three, we have Pancakes and Bacon going up against Susie Sparkles for the Jersey Juniors. Jersey
nice
about to
move there.
Return to a full pack as their pivot returns from the penalty box. 4 points for Susie. Pancakes having a little bit of trouble. Oh,
nice.
That tiny skater, tiny
yep.
hole, perfect match.
Right.
Completes
size
her initial
can
pass.
Be an advantage
yeah.
here. Or lack of size can be an advantage here.
And so we have Ruth List back out on the line really quick for New Hampshire. I think she's very excited about this next jam.
So, you know, New Jersey came out and really took control of the track, but New Hampshire's not letting them get away with it, right? Like, they're staying in the game. Less than 20 points separate these two teams.
I don't know their history. I do know that New Hampshire has played once before at this level.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure Jersey's track record on here, but Jersey has also come in with less skaters at their
yes.
disposal, so that might start to become a factor also. Ruthless is your lead jammer for New Hampshire. Hailstorm able to come out, completing the initial pass.
Look at that fast. Ruthless just wow. coming through. So fast on those skates.
I saw her when she first entered the track. She was ready for that. That was her jam. She had decided.
Out of three times on that Frogmouth Jammer line, Ruthless has picked up three leads. So living up to the name of Ruthless.
Next on the line, we see Susie Sparkles going up against Killer Bunny. I believe that's the first time Killer Bunny's been out here.
Yeah. So I'm just got a note here from our wonderful producer that 20 points of that score is by Ruthless.
Oh, that's so two-thirds of their points thus far.
Mm-hmm.
Lead jammer for Susie Sparkles of Jersey. Killer Bunny having a killer time getting through this pack. Oh, yep. A little bit of lifting of the arms of one of her teammates to help her get through, but recycled. A little unclear. A couple of Jersey skaters heard a whistle. Not sure who it was on. Their pivot has reached the box to serve a penalty.
Little pile up there.
And just in time, Susie calls it off.
Pivot remains in the box. That's cringe in the box. Yep. It's a little difficult to see from our vantage point, but...
We have Hailstorm back on the line for Jersey Juniors going up the infamous Ruthless for New Hampshire. And Hailstorm making short work of that pack. Ruthless not going to let her get away with that.
So Ruthless is like, you took away my 100% jam record.
I'm
the
not
jam record's going to get you.
And I'm sure she could hear her breathing on her heels because the second that Ruthless had a skate past her, she's like, I'm calling it off. You're
yep.
not getting this. Rebel Storm out on the line for New Hampshire. He has taken a star pass, but I don't think he has started as a jammer for them yet this time.
I believe you are correct.
And Susie Sparkles, familiar sight for the juniors, Jersey Juniors.
Yeah, so as I said, the first four jams, Jersey just came out. They had 36 to 10 on the board, but then the next six jams, New Hampshire, turn on the fire. It's 14 to 20 in favor of New Hampshire for the second six jams.
Rebel Storm completing initial pass. And I have to question, we were talking about size before. I've been watching him play the last couple days, and I wonder if his size, he is one of the larger skaters on the field. I wonder if that is actually a hindrance here in level two, because accidentally he could make impact that was not, you know, that could be seen as a penalty, you know, abundance of speed unintentionally. So I was watching as he was on that jam. He seemed to be very, very cautious, and I'm wondering if that is due to not wanting to be in the penalty box a lot.
It is. I mean, you do have to adjust for a lot of different things. Height of, you have to block them in the appropriate area if you're going to block them, and so you might have to get really low.
Ruthless sneaking around the inside line for New Hampshire on her first scoring pass. Ooh, is that cringe again?
Looks like a cut.
Oh no, that is Queenie Hart pivot for Jersey. Ooh, and we have a
cut track
on Hailstorm, Jersey's jammer. So Ruthless is going to be ruthless about scoring points in her absence from the track. Jersey's blockers very wisely trying to move the pack forward, make it a little more difficult.
Nice draw out there to the outside of the track, allowing Ruthless to take that inside lane. Oh, again.
Cinder block being very effective for New Hampshire and holding out the Jersey blockers to the outside line, opening up that inside for Ruthless.
Wow,
16 points.
Girl, now 8 points separating these teams. This is an amazing, so New Hampshire found some fire in the furnace.
Yeah, I think they are, their talents aside, I think they are being helped by the fact that Jersey has consistently kept a blocker in the penalty box.
That is very true. We will definitely take a look at penalties over the intermission.
Susie Sparkles, lead jammer for Jersey. Not going to give this up easily. Eliza Jamilton out there for New Hampshire. I believe this is her first trip to the Frogmouth Jammer Line.
So this is... Lead to Jersey. Okay, yeah. So yeah. Susie Sparkles, yeah. Just making sure I was seeing everything appropriately.
Cut track issued to Eliza Jamilton for New Hampshire. She will spend some time in the penalty box, giving Susie time to increase their score lead. Unless she is going also to the box?
It looked like the penalty was on the pivot there.
Yep, that would be Rebel Storm. Whenever you see skaters sitting on top of other skaters, it's like, whose fault was that?
And again, for those of you not in the venue, occasionally we will have some whistle bleed over because track two is right behind us. Every once in a while, if they hit the right angle, it sounds like the whistles are right here with us, but they are not.
Susie Sparkle is going through. That is, I believe, 16 points for her on this jam. Eliza Jamilton has returned and completed her initial pass for New Hampshire. Coming around on a scoring pass. Susie with another 4 points and decides that's enough.
Yeah. And as soon as I said New Hampshire found the fire in their furnace, New Jersey is going to put a stop to that.
And we do have an official timeout on the floor at 10:51 left on the period clock. It's like a little bit of discussion amongst...
You were mentioning penalties earlier, Bear, and I just want to point out, as we were reading the rosters earlier, you saw that Jersey comes in with a much shorter roster than New Hampshire. At this point, New Jersey has a bit... not more total penalties because they have fewer people, but we have
per person.
Let's see, Cringe is sitting on 3. Queenie Hart has 2 already. Cupcake already has 2. And so when you only have a very, very short roster, that's 9 people, a 9-person roster, those penalties could make be part of our story as
Absolutely.
We enter in the second half.
How is New Hampshire doing? Is anyone sitting in any trouble over there?
No,
I know they have more people at their disposal, but...
Yeah, 2 people with 2 penalties, and there's a couple people with 1, but that's it. They're playing pretty cleanly so far.
And now I'm seeing a timeout is actually charged to New Hampshire. So I'm not sure if we were misinformed originally there was an official timeout, but it does see the timeout is being charged to New Hampshire. And they need to regroup a little bit, perhaps. Do you see Bashanista back out there for New Hampshire and a familiar face Hailstorm for Jersey? Hailstorm actually got pushed down at the last, but did receive that lead jammer status before getting through. And as expected, saw that call off. I think she got it.
I don't know if she was able to pick up any points.
I'm not seeing any points picked up for Bashanista. So excellent timing of that call off by Jersey.
Yeah, it was a very fast. As soon as she saw her bench say call it, she was aware and called it. And that is what you've got to do as a player, because your bench can see so much more of what's happening than you can. So
that makes me think about, we were talking a little bit earlier too about how the impact of the junior programs are going, what they're going to impact the adult program.
Yes.
But in the interim, I want to make sure that we give credit for Susie Sparkle's lead jammer for juniors. Jersey juniors, that's a mouthful. Blue Thunder back on the jammer line for New Hampshire. I know we've seen her once before. Hadn't seen her recently, though. And we do have another. Those were our whistles. I thought they were actually from another track. 4 points added to Jersey's total.
So that was five leads in a row for Susie Sparkles.
Wow. Cupcake back out on the jammer line for Jersey against Ruthless. New Hampshire setting up with an immediate tripod. And I believe what's going to become an offensive blocker. Yes, cinder block. Excellent blocking for her jammer. Ruthless lead jammer for New Hampshire.
Telling you, Ruthless just putting the points on the board.
Ah, beautiful slowdown. Timed it perfectly to avoid any contact from Jersey. 4 points for Ruthless.
Ruthless is totally ruthless.
Cupcake able to complete the initial pass, but Ruthless already threw for another 4 points and decided that's enough for her, bringing New Hampshire a little closer to Jersey's total, 54-78 in favor of Jersey now.
So you can see just a repeat of 44 points for Ruthless. So really doing a great job out there.
So basically almost all of New Hampshire's points are
basically
from Ruthless.
So you're saying, like, the impact of, if you're looking at these skaters, how the talent that they're expressing out there right now.
I know. Imagine, like, honestly, like, I wish I had been able to start Derby at age eight. But, you know, like, the question is, you know, what impact are they going to have? I just was calling an adult game Santa Cruz earlier, and they actually highlighted the fact they have three juniors in their jammer rotation, you know, freshly elevated juniors, I should say. And what that's going to do for all, you know, the adult teams.
Yes, because they don't need a program to help them get into skating. They've already been doing it for 8 to 10 years. You know, like, they already know the rules. They already know how leagues work, nonprofits.
And out of the track here, we have Cringe wearing the star for New Hampshire. And that was Killer Bunny out there for New Hampshire. Or, excuse me, Cringe, Jersey.
Right.
Killer Bunny, New Hampshire.
Right.
Lead jammer. And points for Cringe, 8 of them, to Killer Bunnies, 4 points for New Hampshire.
Sure would like to give a special shout out to the Derby Apex for bringing this live feed to you. The Derby Apex is your independent source for women's flat track derby news, rankings, and more. Visit the DerbyApex.com and follow them on Twitter at the Derby Apex.
Yes, thank you, Apex, for letting us talk to the people who couldn't make it to this wonderful event. We have Devastator out there, number 126 in red for Jersey. And lead jammer, big surprise, that is Ruthless out there, speeding around the track, coming in for some points. Devastator just, not completing, getting a cut track. So Jersey going to sit down in the box. This is an opportune time for Ruthless to be racking up those additional points unopposed.
So, Ruthless... did lose that one lead jammer status and caught the other jammer, but has made 6 out of 7.
That's pretty impressive, and I don't think she has her way. I don't think she'll let that happen again.
I know we're going to add more points to New Hampshire's total from Ruthless. It seems to me that Ruthless is super hyper aware that the defenders can't accelerate into her, so she will walk up to a defender. Come up to a defender instead of waiting for them to approach her.
Yes.
And so that's really an effective way to get through.
Oh, and she got herself a cut track. Just as Devastator comes back from the penalty box, she will report.
I was bragging on you, Ruthless. I'm sorry. This is an announcer curse. It shouldn't work on broadcast. It should not.
To all great things, a fall must come.
Yes.
And
I mean, that in no way takes away from her performance
not
so far out of the track.
Devastator setting some points on the board for Jersey. Ruthless is standing in the penalty box. This will go to the natural 2-minute conclusion due to her loss of lead. And she's going to see if she takes a look at the scoreboard. There are only 3 seconds left in this gym. And she was looking to say, could I possibly get any more points? And the answer is no, not on this turn.
So
another 2 points for Devastator.
I just want to highlight, I wasn't looking at your camera angle, but if you saw, we were talking about size earlier, and you saw the jammer go up against Dred Zeppelin.
Yes.
Okay, Dred Zeppelin, very tall skater, and that was Devastator, who's a very small. Dred Zeppelin has to get down way far, crouch lower than ever to be able to hit legally, and so, or push I guess, lean in legally. So, your small stature might be an actual advantage for you in this game.
Yeah, just like they say in the baseball, your strike zone is tiny.
Yes.
This is your hit zone.
Your touch zone
is itty bitty. We do have Hailstorm lead jammer for Jersey Juniors in red, number 525. And we do have a star pass on the side of New Hampshire. Hello Kitty handing off the star to, I believe that is Blue Thunder.
You are correct, I think.
I am. One of our smaller skaters on the New Hampshire side, by the by.
Mm-hmm. So I think it's a benefit to have multiple sizes on your team as you head out to the track, to have lots of different people.
Absolutely. I mean, the adults have that same effect, too.
Right.
I ran into a super, what I call a super derby fan yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And super derby fans to me are the ones who come to see the derby, do not have any affiliation, not a family or friend of anyone before coming to the derby. Now they're fans and friends of lots of people, of course.
Right.
But they were concerned about the size differentials in here, and I was relaying, even in adults, there are size differences.
Sure,
I mean,
absolutely.
I've skated against 6-foot-tall men and women.
Right.
I had a teammate who was 4'8" and unstoppable.
Right.
So, it works on all levels and all ages.
And you have to find your center of balance. And
right.
If you're 6 feet or if you're 4 feet, it doesn't matter.
And we do have Susie Sparkles, who is your lead jammer for Jersey, calling off before Cinderblock able to score any points in that jam. That brings Jersey to 100 points even. New Hampshire not too far behind them at 70. Just under 2.5 minutes to go in this first half.
Yeah, so Jersey seems to get a fire under them and put some points on the board, but New Hampshire's not letting them run away with it, every time Jersey gets a run, New Hampshire comes back and makes a run. Now, looks like we have one blocker in the box for New Hampshire.
And just was released, that's Rebel Storm. But we do have Hailstorm reporting to the penalty box as jammer for Jersey, which leaves Pancakes and Bacon free and clear. She has established lead jammer for New Hampshire, and she is going to come around for her first scoring pass.
Oh, finds that inside
open. I think that is in part help. Who is that? That's number 11. Hermione Danger and Rebel Storm, both on the larger side, probably some of the older skaters also, really keeping the Jersey skaters away from that inside line for
right, and you see that position. Was it I'm not going to name, but the position of the blocker, you just can kind of stand.
Yes.
And hang on to them because they cannot hit you out of their way.
Yeah.
Rebel Storm, that's who it was.
Rebel Storm, you can only push.
Just you can push against them, but Rebel Storm knows, I'm going to put my back up against these people and hold them, and they can't accelerate into me. And that's just a really great strategy move, right? Like, and opens up that lane, and the jammer's just able to lap every gun.
We do have New Hampshire's pivot sitting in the penalty box. That's Hermione Danger.
Shocker.
But Ruthless didn't need that extra blocker there for her. Lead jammer again up against Cupcake, who was not too far, about a quarter of the track behind. Ruthless gets her points and calls it off. She's ruthless. She's not allowing any points for the other team.
But, you know, I mean, that is, if you're Cupcake, that's you. Like, if you cannot get out before Ruthless, then your job is to get out as quickly as possible and force the call off.
Yep.
Yeah.
We're going to see Blue Thunder out on the line for New Hampshire up against, I believe that is Hailstorm, yes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think we're actually not going to get it off because, oh, we
did.
Just as the period clock. As the period clock is expiring, this final jam of the half will go. And Hailstorm, lead jammer for Jersey in this final jam of the half. Blue Thunder having a little bit of trouble with Jersey's blockers.
Oh, yeah, they can just kind of sit and stand there, and inside lane opens up. Yep,
they were waiting for her to come back on the outside. And the question is Hailstorm going to allow for any points? No.
So yeah, we will tick down right into halftime. This is great. That went by really fast.
It did.
Because they are, an exciting team, even though this isn't, the full accelerated hit that you would see in level 3. But still, they're doing a great job out there.
And the positional blocking is phenomenal because you're seeing both teams really working together and holding the opposing jammer back. And still occasionally having, you see, every once in a while you saw one little bit of offense, sneaking, helping them sneak around that inside line. But also you see some very intelligent jammers who are kind of like, I trust the blocker. My blockers are taking care of the opposition. I'm just going to look for my little holes. And
they do.
Zoom.
And they have put up some great points. We're currently 104 and 82. And so we will come back in about 8-ish, 7 or 8 minutes. So refresh your beverage and come back and stay with us for the rest of this conclusion of Jersey Junior Roller Derby taking on New Hampshire Junior Roller Derby. Hi, welcome back.
That was dancing.
I was not right. There's some good music happening in this venue. Welcome back to Jersey Junior Roller Derby taking on New Hampshire Junior Roller Derby. I'm Murphy Longstocking.
I am Don't Care Bear. Dancing,
doing a great job. So we just want to talk to you a little bit about what you saw in the first half. So, as we said, New Jersey comes in with a 9-person roster, okay, and New Hampshire with a full roster of 15, right?
Yes.
And so when I was taking a look at the penalties, Jersey has 14 total between their team.
Okay.
New Hampshire sitting at 10. So what I think certainly New Jersey has to do for this half is a must clean it up. Because if you lose a person or two,
you're down to basically single rotation.
You're literally going to players are going to get really winded. They're not going to be able to perform as well because they're not going to get a break. And also when we look at jammer penalties in particular, we have 5 jammer penalties for New Jersey and we have 3 for New Hampshire. So that's a fairly big difference.
Considerable difference.
When you've got fewer jammers to rotate in and they're getting more penalties, it's it can play out some in the second half here as we're looking towards this. Now, New Jersey has put more points on the board.
Yeah, but New Hampshire is not, especially with Ruthless, not going to let them get away with that for a moment. I have one other question, and this is, adults versus children, because I remember having boundless energy as a child, not so much as an adult, so I'm curious to know that not, on an adult roster, 9 skaters, you're exhausted by the end of that half.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have the time to, to recuperate and come back in the second half. I don't think that's quite as much of an issue for the kids, for the juniors. I could be wrong, but I have a feeling their resilience is a little bit higher.
They do have a lot of resilience, but I think it's a different kind of tired, muscular. They don't have the muscle build that a full, some of the adults we have. But, as an adult, you got to carry all that around with you.
Right.
you might get tired.
AK, our producer is demonstrating how exhausted we all are. So, right. But anyway, I wonder if that does have play into it. Because, I remember being a kid, I used to be able to stay up all day, all night, and do it again the next day. And now I'm like, no, can't do that anymore.
Right. But I think this level of physical activity is just a different kind of tired.
I'm not saying they're not tired. I'm just curious. You know.
I think they might rebound a lot quicker than any of us do. But.
Thoughts for...
So again, we do an equipment check at the beginning of the game. We do an equipment check at halftime to make sure, because, even though this is not acceleration into hitting, there's lots of falling, there's lots of pushing against people, there's just lots of contact out there. And so we did like to double check the juniors. And anyone who's curious, in the venue, we do have the JRDA code of conduct that is posted outside of tracks that will be hosting the junior teams. And so everyone in the venue, including audience, everybody has to abide by the JRDA code of conduct.
And I did see yesterday during a game, the referees came over and had a couple words with a couple of the audience members.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a strong suspicion that was directly related to that code of conduct.
Yes. So it is. When you come in, not only are there minors on the track, but they often bring family members, and so there are lots and lots of minors in the room. And so we just want to all pay attention to that stuff.
It's like a couple of the jersey skaters need to adjust helmets.
Yeah.
And I know I've done a couple of officiating gigs in my day, and
mm-hmm.
I have always been a stickler for making sure those helmets are tight. You don't want it to be choking
Absolutely.
Them, but you do not want that helmet to kick back. So I see a couple adjustments being made, referees double-checking those helmets.
Right. They do actually, put their fingers under the chin strap and move the helmet and make sure it's secure on the head, which is so important. Head injuries are not a joke.
No. And those, it doesn't matter whether you're a child or
right.
an adult, those are devastating regardless of age
do not
or
need
experience. So to start off this half, we have our illustrious Ruthless for New Hampshire in the black wearing number 3, and we have number 222 Susie Sparkles in red for New Jersey on our Frogmouth Jammer line.
So again, you are watching level 2 Derby. No acceleration into hitting, although they can lean on one another and push.
And I got a little hip tap there by number 23, Queenie Hart on Ruthless. And Ruthless, not lead jammer. That status goes to Susie Sparkles, even though she is behind Ruthless. And Wisely calls it off, preventing points from being scored.
That's got to be a win in Jersey's mind. Just keeping Ruthless from getting lead and putting all those points on the board that she always does.
Hailstorm, number 525 in red for Jersey on the line, going up against 1105 Blue Thunder in the pink and black.
So just getting a note here, they did keep Ruthless scoreless, but 60 points in that first half.
No.
Ruthless has been.
And that is another lead jam status for Jersey.
Uh-oh.
Whatever
Jersey's
their pep talk
here.
Was. Whatever their pep talk at halftime was clearly got through. And I see, when they're coming this way, I keep thinking they're going the penalty box, but that was just an enormous drawback on Blue Thunder by Devastator.
Oh, so yeah, can't stay on that line. That's the same for level 3 Derby as it is for level 2. Don't go to the line because they will bump you right out.
Yep. And I hate to dwell on size, but we do have the two tiny dancers, as it were. Devastator doing a great job holding back Blue Thunder for quite some time. She did just complete her initial pass, but wisely called off by Jersey before she was able to come around for those points.
So it looks like they're going to have Ruthless on the every other jammer rotation here.
Well, I would if I were them.
I mean, I certainly am not judging them in any way.
If I thought she could handle it, I'd probably
put her
every time. Going up against Ruthless is 709 Cupcake for Jersey. And there goes Ruthless. Lead jammer, but Cupcake hot on her heels.
Yeah, Cupcake has had some success out here on the track.
Absolutely.
28 points in the first half for Cupcake.
A rather impressive total.
Mm-hmm.
And there goes Ruthless, and she is calling it as quickly as she can. Did she prevent any points? Yep. Zero for Cupcake, so successful jam for New Hampshire. 4-0 on the board. 110 to 86 for New Hampshire.
Cupcake was just had on the fire there. Couldn't stop herself from skating around the track.
Yeah.
She had that laser-sharp focus on getting out of the pack and trying to get around there.
I don't want to do an announcer jinx, but so far so good on the penalty box.
We're not going to say anything right now.
Nope.
We're just going to keep talking about the track.
Hailstorm back out there for Jersey in red. Lead jammer Eliza Jamilton having a little trouble in the back of the pack for New Hampshire. I think right now New Hampshire is more focused on defense. She's kind of left on her own to find her way through the pack. Ooh, oh, ow.
Ow, that looked like that hurt. You did not see that on your camera,
yeah,
I don't think.
Yeah, her feet came out from underneath her. We're talking about Eliza Jamilton here. And she took a bit of a face plant to the track. Does seem to have recovered.
Yeah, she doesn't see. Oh, no. But now receives a cut track penalty.
Cut track. And her bench is like, just go, 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 go.
Yeah, just go sit in the box. We'll talk about it later.
Yeah, I think that fall kind of disoriented her
a
little bit.
Yeah, that was a big.
She's not look happy about her status right now. I wouldn't.
I also would not be. So that is the fourth penalty for Jamilton. And
for the amount of time that she's been out there, are those all jammer penalties for her? Or was she yelled at? Did she get some of it as a blocker?
You know what? I'm going to say there were some as a blocker because there aren't as many jammer penalties as she had. We couldn't divide up the jammer penalties and have her.
Perfect.
So,
she has returned from the box, stepping back onto the track at turn one.
Yeah, maybe she was able to sit for a minute and get her wits about her.
Being knocked into the infield by a trio led by Cringe.
Oh.
Hailstorm making short work of New Hampshire's blockers there for that final pass.
What a great
24
run.
24 points for her on that.
Amazing.
Nothing
jam.
For New Hampshire. Is that our highest score? That
Vegas
is our
jam.
Highest scoring jam right there. Congratulations, Hailstorm.
Yeah. Just Hailstorm, the whole time we were talking about all the things happening and the penalties and whatever. You know, Hailstorm was just lapping, just calmly
very
lapping
consistent.
The track, and then makes the biggest jam of the game.
Yes. There goes Ruthless on the inside of the big hit, but legal by number 23, Queenie Hart. And that was good enough to spring out Susie Sparkles as your lead. Ruthless not far behind her. Susie's going to have to think really hard about how many points she actually needs up to sign a run right through and then call it. So, see, did Ruth.
I
was
think
Ruth
was able to get some.
Two. Yeah. I see two being held up. Still a positive score, jam differential there for Jersey, though, so probably worth the risk.
I feel like Jersey is. I feel like the strategy of Jersey and, at this point is run it just run out and get as many points as we can and do as best we can as we while we have all these folks on the track. Just run it hard. Just go out there, folks. And
Devastator takes down all three of New Hampshire's blockers and escapes lead jammer. Blue Thunder being drawn back by Cringe. Jersey's pivot at this time. And Dread Zeppelin coming out of the penalty box for New Hampshire. Hopefully going to be able to give Blue Thunder a little bit of help.
Devastator has got a fan club in the house.
Well, they do have the advantage. They can get probably more local fans.
Yes,
you know, being
yes,
just,
that's true.
Just one state over.
But it's... They
I believe the Jersey Juniors are based out of the Morristown area, which is like north central Jersey. We're directly across from like the southern part of New Jersey, so probably still a good hour for their fans to get here. So good dedication from the fans. Who do we have? Oh, Cinderblock out on the jammer line for New Hampshire, struggling at the back of the pack as. Who is that? That is a taller skater. That is Queenie Hart on the jammer line. First time out there for her. That's why I didn't recognize her quickly. I don't see that in the jammer often.
Queenie Hart doing some good work on the toe stops.
Yeah. And Cinderblock able to escape on her, complete her initial pass as well. Rocking the sparkle flare skirt.
I like that.
And I only mentioned it because she's going so fast that it's flowing nicely
wave.
In the wind.
I know, right?
Aesthetically pleasing on the track.
I like it.
She was able to score 1 point in that jam to Queenie's 8 points, 150-89 in favor of Jersey. 21 minutes and change to her.
Want to also give a huge shout out to Frogmouth, who is sponsoring our jammer line. Frogmouth roller derby uniforms and practice wear, size inclusive, gender neutral, skater made, woman owned, and derby owned. That's Frogmouth.
And this year we have Pancakes and Bacon out on the track for New Hampshire. Lead and jammer goes to Pancakes, her New Jersey counterpart. That looks like Hailstorm to me, and I would be correct. Having a little trouble with the Rebel Storm in the back of the pack. Rebel Storm is being helped out by Killer Bunny.
Oh no.
And successfully sends Hailstorm to the penalty track. Penalty box. I saw a hand gesture by her jam ref. I'm not sure. She might actually be serving two penalties.
Oh, maybe. I didn't see the second.
Nope.
But
showing a cut track on our penalty tracking, so we'll go with that. Pancakes and Bacon already around for two separate scoring passes, 8 points, looking for some more.
You know that's Ruthless playing defense out there that just got sent to the penalty box.
That's not good on two levels. Both that, you don't want any of your high-ranking jammers to get into any trouble.
Ruthless just has all the moves, is what I'm thinking.
I think so. She's probably one of the utility. I haven't seen her out with the pivot, though.
Yeah,
so.
That's it. I think she's wearing the pivot stripe.
Oh.
Is that her with the pivot stripe there? And then,
you so are correct.
Those of you who are in our viewing audience, we are actually looking at the track through both a chain link fence as well as a netting. And so sometimes the penalty box and... different NSO officials table and all of that aren't always clear. But we're trying to bring you the best derby we can.
Fashionista back on the line for New Hampshire, finds it very wide open inside track. Lead jammer goes to New Hampshire. And I think that is Susie Sparkles out there for Jersey, completing her initial pass. Fixing some gear along the way. And Fashionista not letting her get any points, gets her 4 points and calls it off. Jersey sitting at 150 points, New Hampshire up to 104 points, just over 18 and a half minutes to go in this game.
I know. As we said, this is exactly what we were talking about when we came in from halftime. Like, New Jersey will make a run for it and put a bunch of points on the board, and then New Hampshire puts a stop to it and makes a run as well. We're kind of back and forth between runs.
We got a high block right off the line on Eliza Jamilton. I think that is her fifth penalty. Yeah, she is getting herself into a little bit of trouble, as well as keeping New Hampshire from being able to score points. Lead jammer will go to Hailstorm instead for Jersey Juniors. Yeah, for her first scoring pass, taking the outside line,
nice.
Successfully getting around all four of New Hampshire's blockers.
Yeah, Rebel Storm trying to get a hit, but again, you can't swing and hit, but trying to get a hip displaced there and was not able to land it, so.
Hailstorm coming around on a second scoring pass. Eliza Jamilton has re-entered the track and is working on completing her initial pass. Cringe pivot for Jersey is giving her a little trouble with that, recycling her far behind the pack. I'm not sure why she went quite that far back.
Yeah. Getting a little bleed over from the teams warming up on the sideline. That's okay. They need a little energy on the track as well.
12 points total there for Jersey, added to their total. Did shut out New Hampshire in that jam. Not surprising, seeing as they started the penalty box.
Yes. I mean, that was such a quick penalty right off the jam line. And that was a high block they called. Again, that has to do with getting lower if you have a shorter team.
Eliza Jamilton, one of the taller skaters out there on the track, so not surprising. Another tall skater here for New Hampshire. Hella Kitty taking the line. Out against Cupcake for Jersey, who is already on a scoring pass. Ella Kitty coming up, taking the time to slow down. Hearing whistles, must have been bleed over from the other side. Ella Kitty able to slide around the outside for 4 points.
They were 4-4 so far. Oh.
Big pile up on the track.
All kinds of whistles there. A little stop there.
Giving a cut track to Ella Kitty. She was a little confused.
Right, there were a couple of whistles right there in a row.
She is joined by one of her blockers. Looks like Dred Zeppelin joining her in the box. Excellent work by Queenie Hart, assisting her jammer through. 12 points for Jersey on that jam, 5 for New Hampshire. So before reporting to the penalty box, Hella Kitty did eke out 1 point on that next scoring pass.
So in the second half, New Jersey has well outnumbered New Hampshire in lead jammer status. We have 8 lead jammer stati going to New Jersey and 3 going to New Hampshire.
So a little confusion. Blue Thunder? Oh no, Pancakes and Bacon out on the jammer line, not realizing that Hella Kitty is still in the penalty box as jammer.
Yeah.
Sent off the track. No penalty is issued for that. That's just a miscommunication from her bench. Lead jammer goes to Devastator for
Jersey. A little hand smile.
He was flying around the track.
Right. And I also want to point out, in terms of jammer penalties, so not only has New Jersey picked up now 9 leads to New Hampshire's 3, they've only sent the jammer to the box once, whereas New Hampshire sent 3 trips to the box.
That definitely is going to make a difference.
Here we're seeing New Jersey the outperforming New Hampshire here in the second half, a lot more than so than the first half.
They do have Ruthless back out on the track, though, for New Hampshire. That might help them, and it does. Lead jammer goes to Ruthless of New Hampshire. Mm-hmm. Susie Sparkle still caught up behind Cinderblock, and that was Bastionista.
Another
did get knocked down, able to succeed. Cinderblock given a penalty.
Yeah.
Followed right behind her. I believe that is Bastionista that just followed her to the penalty box. So both of New Hampshire's blockers that were holding up the jammer for Jersey sent to the penalty box. Very full box. Two from each team right now sitting or standing in the box.
Wow.
And we're getting an official timeout. I think there's a lot of confusion, probably having to do with some of these penalties and how many skaters are where.
Wow. So neither team really as clean this half as they had been in the first half. So in terms of team penalties, we have New Jersey at 19. Actually, New Jersey only put five more penalties on their list here. New Hampshire, 21 total penalties.
Wow.
So remember, they came into the half with 10 penalties.
So they have definitely been sitting more time in the box. We were talking about, you know, how exhaustion and how so it could be mental exhaustion.
Mm-hmm.
Starting to take a toll.
Lack of focus, yeah.
Paying attention. I've seen, you know, looking at the penalties being called. I see a lot of forearms and low blocks. That's often, I don't want to say lazy penalties, but, you know, more easily avoidable penalties.
When you get tired,
yeah, you stop paying
them,
attention. Right. You start swinging your arms a little bit.
Right.
Maybe you kick your leg or you don't skate as cleanly.
And so I was giving the warning to New Jersey as we came into this half about penalties, and I guess I should have also said New Hampshire, because New Hampshire now more than doubling their penalties in the second half, and we're a little over halfway through the second half. They've already doubled.
And I am seeing that there's only one person who's really in major danger, and that's number 19, Eliza Jamilton. New Hampshire with lead. That is Blue Thunder with Hailstorm hot on her heels, coming up to New Hampshire in the rear of the pack. And Hailstorm able to squeak out 2 points. Blue Thunder did not receive any points on that jam, so did not call it off in time. Jersey and New Hampshire both sitting on 3 blockers in their pack. They each have a blocker standing in the penalty box, so they will be returning to track within the next 10 seconds. Ruthless out front, not lead. Lead jammer status went to Susie Sparkles, who very wisely calls it off before Ruthless is able to sneak in there any points. Cringe back in the jammer box for Jersey.
That is Cringe. Cringe is sitting on 4 penalties.
I've seen Cringe go a couple times.
Oh, now five.
I was thinking that might have started to be some trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Joined also in the penalty box. I'm seeing a 3, so it must be 13 Candy, because they don't have a number 3.
Or Queenie Hart, either.
Is it 23?
Those are the 2 threes.
Yeah, whoever it is, she's sitting down. Not sitting down, getting lead jammer status is Pancakes and Bacon for New Hampshire. Coming around on a scoring pass, getting a little help from Rebel Storm, her pivot.
You're right, it was 13. That is Candy.
And being joined by their jammer, Hailstorm, not what you want to see when they have the momentum on their side, but both blockers sprinting back onto the track. Right behind Pancakes and Bacon, going to have to pay attention, make sure they're not
Right.
Accelerating into
Nice job. Yeah,
beautiful job by Cringe.
Cringe.
Oh, and not so beautiful. A little bit of a high block. And that is six for Cringe.
Oh, it was such a good move.
It was beautiful. He's just well timed, just maybe not executed as cleanly as hoped. Paintings make it, with an actual hit. I saw that coming. I was like, I knew that was coming. That was a hitting penalty on number 23, Queenie Hart.
Now that brings Queenie Hart to six. With this last. No, they haven't put up that other one.
Ah.
She's been sitting at five for the last couple of minutes. So
got it. So she'll be at six as well.
Yeah, so there'll be two players on Jersey. Now, this is where we talked about. This could be a story. They have kept it clean for most of this half, but with only a nine-person roster, you got to be careful with those two players sitting
and
on six.
Jersey taking a timeout right now. Perhaps that is something they were going to discuss with their team about settle down, calm. Pay attention to how you're hitting and where you're putting your positions.
Now, I don't see Queenie Hart getting the six recorded, but that she has been sitting on five for a good bit. So, I'm just looking at technology. It's not always perfect. Humans are recording things in technology. Maybe it is five, and then just maybe there was a highlighting issue.
A glitch in the matrix, as it were.
I was just looking at the highlight, so maybe, the highlight was incorrect. But anyway, still one with five and one with six. That's
when you only have nine skaters, that's a lot to worry about.
So Ruthless, I just have a little tidbit of information. Ruthless, who dominated the first half with points. New Jersey has kind of put a damper on that a little bit. Ruthless only now, she's only got 10 points.
Only.
New Jersey taking some time to spend on Ruthless, and of course it's to say that.
There she is, lead jammer again, but, immediately runs through, gets her 4 points and calls it off before Susie can come around. And I'm curious the strategy on that. She definitely has the extra speed and clearly the, maneuverability to work her way around the track. I'm curious to know if, maybe New Hampshire let her run the jams a little longer and, did a little bit of points trading. She's got the speed on her side.
Yeah.
And she might, especially out there, Rebel Storm and Hermione Danger doing a great job holding together their walls. Maybe you should give a little bit of long pointing going on, but they've decided to put Blue Thunder out there, who has also received lead jammer status, coming around strong. Oh dear. I think that was partly seeing a little size disadvantage. She hit the wall and just basically toppled over. Unfortunately, did not call it off as quickly as I think her bench would have hoped. 0-3 in favor of Jersey on that jam. Bringing our total 183 to 125 with just under 8 minutes to go.
I think that's Rebel Storm. Rebel Storm in the penalty box right now, sitting with five for New Hampshire.
Dear.
Also 19, we mentioned before, Eliza Jamilton still sitting on that five. So penalties do start to play a role as we get here. There's 7.5 minutes left in the second half.
I see Nitro coming out of the penalty box for Jersey. That was her first penalty, it looks like, if I'm reading the board correctly. Ruthless, lead jammer, on a scoring pass, making a run for it. But calling off before getting any, letting Jersey get any points. Another 4 points for Ruthless.
So, yeah, whatever the halftime conversation was, certainly Ruthless was a part of it for Jersey, right? So they had some discussions about Ruthless and were like, we got to put a stop to this multiple scoring pass kind of jamming. And they've done that. And they've done that.
Dred Zeppelin out there on the line for New Hampshire. I think we've seen that once before in the first half, but not in their usual rotation.
Right.
And it's Hailstorm for Jersey.
Dred Zeppelin, though, finding some resistance on that defense from New Jersey.
And again, I'm going to question, where does size and ability come into this? Dred Zeppelin a taller skater, definitely has a very different style of skating than, for example, Ruthless does. Probably has to be a little more cautious about approaching the pack.
Right. Yeah, your momentum as a bigger person just is more, right? And so
yes.
You have to slow it down. Have to get lower to block appropriately, to hit people in their legal blocking zones.
Yeah. Well, even at level 3 or at the adult level, size does matter.
Yes.
And, you know, like I am a stronger, larger skater, shall we say, and often found myself the recipient of back blocks because I just would not be able to control my momentum.
Right.
But controlling her momentum and her speed, Ruthless, once again, lead jammer for New Hampshire, coming through the pack on a scoring pass. Taken down, unsure who's to blame for that takedown, but Devastator able to sneak out in the kerfuffle for his initial pass. And Ruthless being sent to the penalty box.
Oh. So
looks like
low
an
block, is that what that,
yeah
there
block?
We go. I'll confirm that for you. That's what it looks like over here on the penalty tracker.
Yep. So just over 5 minutes to go, and she's going to be sitting for 30 seconds on that. Devastator putting up 4 points on the board. Cinderblock joining her jammer in the penalty box. So when Ruthless comes out, she will not have the opportunity to pass that star should she choose to, with her pivot no longer available.
Oh, that amazing defense there. But Devastator, really impressed there. Just kept working back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. And eventually that wall can't move with you. They will make a misstep somewhere. And I found that open lane and took it.
Oh, Ruthless taking advantage of her taller skaters and skating right under their arms and around for her 4 points. The Devastator already at 8 points, and I believe just added another 12 total for Devastator on this jam. Just a few seconds left before the natural conclusion of this 2-minute jam. But Ruthless is going to get as many points as she possibly can, another 4 for her. Devastator working on his 4th pass. And 15 total for Devastator on that one. Only, quote unquote, 8 for New Hampshire.
Right. So Dred Zeppelin, after that last one, is now sitting on 4. So just to review penalties, New Jersey has 107. The Cringe at 6. Number 23, Queenie Hart at 5. We have New Hampshire 071, A Rebel Storm with 5. And 19, Eliza Jamilton with 5.
We have Cupcake back out on the jammer line and racing through the pack for lead jammer status for Jersey. Pancakes and Bacon having a little trouble at the back of the pack, getting an assist from Dred Zeppelin. Meanwhile, Cupcake already threw for 4 points and decided to call it off.
Just like to give a shout out to Frogmouth for sponsoring our jammer line today. That's Frogmouth roller derby uniforms and practice wear, size inclusive, gender neutral, skater made, woman owned, and derby owned.
When this jam starts, we'll have Susie Sparkles for Jersey up against Bastionista for New Hampshire. We've seen her out here a couple times. Not really in their full rotation, though. It should be lead jammer.
Yeah.
Ashley is able to get out first. Susie Sparkles right on her tail coming into the back of the pack.
I think Bastionista might have gotten lead the last time she wore the star. And so not a bad choice there.
And was able to call it off. She just got 1 point.
But 4 points total. Okay, so three times, jam. Yeah, so I missed one. But 4 points plus one.
Just got one in the past one. Jersey is sitting at 206 points to New Hampshire's 138. We have just about a minute and a half left in this game. And Cupcake making quick work of the pack.
Already
around on the starting pass. And Blue Thunder does get out on the initial pass. Has a long way to go to catch up to Cupcake, though.
Again, that was that size element there. Blue Thunder just needed a couple of inches and made that outside lane work for her.
A little confusion, but Rebel Storm reporting to the penalty box.
Oh, no, that is six for Rebel Storm.
Dear,
six. So we're under a minute.
He will
so
not be
maybe
returning to the game.
Okay, well. We might get another jam in here. We'll see.
Cinder block lining up in hopes of getting that Devastator. Number 126 in red for Jersey. Taking the outside. Cinder block working against three blockers for Jersey up front. Wisely keeping her hands behind her back.
Yeah.
Penalty prevention position, I call that. Drawn back successfully by Cringe, giving Devastator time and space on the inside line to get out first. Lead jammer goes to Jersey and Devastator.
Here comes Cinderlock also out of the pack. Everybody's gonna have to slow down. Okay.
Ooh.
That was interesting the way center block came through kind of like sideways a little bit, so not to pick up that back block.
And also using some of her larger blockers to help slow down her momentum. Center block coming through again. They're almost trading points at this point, which at the end of the game is really in Jersey's favor or in nobody's favor because
right now it's an 8-8
point differential is just
now Devastator. Devastator, and that is a penalty on, I think, Rebel Storm.
Didn't see him come off. I think he was just doing a drawback.
It came to the bench. So that was not a call. I apologize. Yeah. So
unofficially, Jersey has taken this game 218 points to New Hampshire's 150. A lot of good action. Thankfully, no injuries. I don't ever say that until the end of the end of the game.
there is an announcer's curse, apparently.
No foul outs.
That works on the broadcast. So.
In spite of having some worries about their penalties, neither team had anyone foul out.
They kept it really close there at the end. Oh, jammer. Jammer sent to the box. Seven each team.
Wow. Well, at least they kept it
so,
even.
Yeah.
We do now have an official final. Jersey 218, New Hampshire 150. And glad to see you don't see it because they've gone back and looking at our lovely faces. But lots of fans lining the track to get those hand slaps and those congratulations for those juniors who really both put on a great game.
It really was. It really was a great game. And I don't think either team has anything to be embarrassed about at all.
Well,
I mean, New Jersey coming in here with a 9-person roster. That's
really
difficult to pull off, and they won, they won just with really steady. I mean, the penalties were 26 for New Jersey, 25 for New Hampshire. Again, we had jammers in the box, 7 for New Jersey, 7 for New Hampshire. We had leads, 29 for New Jersey, 21 for New Hampshire.
Very evenly matched game,
but New Jersey just come up with a win.
Yeah, we just got those sneak those extra points in.
We did.
That wraps it up for us for now.
It is. It does. Stay tuned because we have so much more Derby.
Thank you, Apex, for letting us stream this.
On track three, we're on track three. It'll be London taking on Santa Cruz. Track two.
I'm going to track two, but I'm not going to be up here. Banadnock Juniors taking on the Darlings of Destruction. That is a level three juniors game, so that'll be full on heavy hard
full
hitting.
Full on hitting. So stay tuned and come on back all day long. We'll be here.
I'm Don't Care Bear.
I'm Ruby Longstocking.
Thank you.
And this is AK.